In this portion of the FX300 ES Plus overview, we are going to take a look at both const and conversion features as well as the change of base mode. The const or constant feature represents 40 built-in scientific constants available to you in any mode other than base conversion. Each scientific constant is displayed as a unique symbol, for example the symbol for pi. To demonstrate, we will compute 1 divided by the square root of the electric constant times the magnetic constant. To do this, we press shift const, and we just need to know the number of the particular constant as referenced on the case of your calculator. In this case, 32 represents the electric constant, and again 33 represents the magnetic constant, and pressing equals will compute that value, which happens to be the speed of light in a vacuum. The 40 available constants cover values from the mass of a proton to the speed of light and many more. Similarly, we also have a metric conversion feature with 40 predefined metric conversions. For instance, to convert 5 centimeters to inches, we would enter 5 and then say that we want to convert. And then again, you need to know the appropriate conversion number. So in this case, converting to inches from centimeters to inches is option 2. I press equals, and there's our value, which we can toggle slightly under 2. Or perhaps if we want to convert 100 grams into ounces, we would enter 100, convert, grams to ounces is conversion 22, and we press equals. And there we have 100 grams is 3.527, etc. ounces. Lastly, we want to take a look at base n mode, which allows us to convert between decimal, hexadecimal, binary, and octal modes, or to actually compute within those modes. So we'll press mode, option 4 for base n. We start off in decimal mode. Decimal mode is the one we're very familiar with. I want to point out that if we do 4 divided by 3, decimal mode will not show you actual decimal values as far as anything that's not an integer. Nothing less than an integer will show up. It will be truncated. However, what we can do now is if I put something in, let's say 9 in decimal mode, if I want to check that out in binary mode, I do not need to press shift or anything. I will simply press this key for binary. And that is the representation in binary mode, or octal mode, or hexadecimal mode, and so on. To do a couple other computations, we'll shift back to binary mode, and we'll look at what is 11 plus 1. Of course, that's not strictly 11 in binary, but when we make that computation in binary, that is what it looks like. If we switch over to hexadecimal, that's represented by the number 4. If I want to compute a hexadecimal value, you can actually use the A, B, C, D, E, F keys here to represent digits that are larger than 9. So for instance, 1F. You'll notice I did not press alpha, by the way. If you press alpha, it will not give you the correct value. This slightly bolded F is the hex F. So 1F plus 1 comes out as so. And if we wanted to convert that back to binary or back to decimal, it's a simple matter of toggling through these. That wraps up our look at the constant and conversion features, as well as base n.